Good morning. Welcome to Member Focus Monday. I'm Christina Schaefer, Director of Social Media for HAR. And this morning, we have a returning guest to our show, Nicole Lopez Cummins, who represents medium firms on our HAR Board of Directors. Welcome, Nicole.
Hey, Christina. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you for returning on our program. Last time you were on, you were talking about millennials and home buying based on some research that you did, which was really enlightening and very helpful. But today you're here to talk about something very different, which is getting involved with HAR, which you know a lot about and we'll get to in just a little bit. But for anyone who doesn't know who you are and that you're on our board of directors and all the things you do, could you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, absolutely, Christina. So my name is Nicole Lopez. I'm the founder of True Houston Real Estate, and I serve on various committees here at the local MLS and also state level. And I know we'll get into all of those a little bit later, but for now, you guys can call me the committee queen.
Exactly. And you'll understand why a little bit later. But out of curiosity, because I think it helps our members who might be considering to get involved, you know, a little bit of your backstory, excuse me. So how long you've been in real estate and when did you first get involved with HAR?
Yeah, so I've been in real estate since 2010. I started on the builder side of things and I was licensed shortly afterward in 2012. So been a realtor now for 9 going on 10 years, which I can't believe it's even been that long. It's flown by. I come from a family that revolves around the real estate market. My mom works for a national home builder and my father's in the mortgage industry. So it was kind of like I didn't really have a choice but to be in real estate. So, but besides that, family in real estate, I've done it for 10 years. And I got involved with HAR about 5 years ago. So I really wanted to learn how HAR worked and operated and how I could have opportunity through the association. I saw so many realtors that I looked up to and respected that were a part of various different committees. And so I just kind of dipped my toe in. You know, the first year that I applied back in 2015 for a committee, I didn't get accepted. And I kept trying. And 2016, I was granted the opportunity by Roz to be a part of YPN. And it's just kind of grown from there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very good. So do you feel, I mean, I know that's now been 5 years. Do you feel that getting involved has impacted your career at all?
Yeah, absolutely. So like I spoke about before, Christina, so many of the professionals in our industry that I respected and regarded so highly were very much involved, going back to like Katie Kosev and so many others I saw that were involved. And it has impacted my career. It's built relationships with realtors in the industry. It's allowed for me to expand my platform in terms of some of the public speaking opportunities that I've been able to do. It's increased and grown my business. Now I'm able to receive referrals not only from HAR members, but from members across the state and the country just through the involvement that I have here. So it's definitely been a worthwhile cause. Not only that, but I feel like it has allowed those of us that are involved to really shape the direction in which HAR goes. HAR is an MLS that really does listen to its members and does put the member first. And so through that, it's been really awesome to have a seat at that table.
Absolutely. So what advisory groups are you currently involved with and what do those advisory groups do?
Okay, hold on 1 second. I have a list, Christina. Past committees that I've served on. So I've served on many committees: MLS, Technology, YPN, TREPAC, Governmental Affairs. I'm next year's Engaged Chair, so I'm super excited about that, you guys. I'm a director representing medium firms for HAR's Board of Leadership. And then on the state level, I'm also a member with Texas YPN, as well as a TREPAC trustee for Region 14, which represents Houston, where I serve as co-chair for orientation. And I'm also a board member at the state level.
Very busy.
Yes. And I'm also a TRLP graduate, I'm a major investor, and I'm an MLS Platinum subscriber.
Well, you again, you just stay busy. But what I liked to hear from that is that it's very well-rounded, and you kind of are picking and choosing where you want to get involved. And it sounds a little strategic because you're wanting to get a little bit of everything there. So that's great. So there's a lot of advisory groups. Obviously, you just mentioned a ton of them. But can you tell us just each of the advisory groups, if you could almost just go down a list of the advisory groups that are available and, you know, what they do and how they impact HAR?
Yeah, absolutely. So some of the ones that I've served on, like YPN, that's our Young Professionals Network. It's for those under 40. And it's a really great way to build leaders within our industry. I think a great example, or a couple of great examples of that, would be Kenya Burrell Van Warmer, Jennifer Wahab. There's so many that have gone through the program of YPN and have really gotten involved in leadership and have taken that by the reins. So that's YPN. We do a lot of events through HAR. We are really the event committee. So 20 under 40 and the Ted Jones talk that usually goes on in the beginning of the year. We do Rebuilding Together Houston, where we get out in the community and help a homeowner that's in need of some repair on their homes. Let's talk about Tree Pack. Now, that's one that's really near and dear to me because that is really, that is such an important committee when it comes to fighting for realtor and homeowner rights in the state. We partner with different legislators. We are the purple party. We don't swing Democrat or Republican. We're right in the middle. And we make sure that the candidates that we support really do have realtor-focused initiatives in mind, and they align with our values as realtors. I've served on governmental affairs, which kind of ties in with Tree Pack. Let me think. Yeah, I mean, there's professional development, there's MLS. MLS goes through and we talk about certain things that we could change within the platform itself and what members are really needing when it comes to MLS services. There is technology that is always led by the fabulous Tiki, who comes up with all of the amazing technology tools that we have. Professional development is, you know, that's growth. That is, you know, the classes and the coursework that we have that's available, and also still building leaders through the Texas Realtors Leadership Program, and so many more. And then next year, of course, I'm chairing Engage, which is our big technology conference. This year, you guys, it's on October 13th and 14th. We have some amazing speakers that are coming. We have Stefan Swanepoel, we've got Tom Ferry, we have Chelsea Pites, Marky Lemons, who else? Tom Ferry. So there are just so many speakers that are coming to this. It's free, so make sure you don't forget to register for that. And I know you guys have the link, so drop it down below so you guys can get registered. There's also an option to make a donation to the Houston Food Bank. I know that last year, like, thousands of dollars were raised. Mm-hmm. And so I know that Rui and Mishika would really love to see that number come up this year.
Absolutely. And I know we also have several staff directors watching this morning that serve as liaisons to a lot of the groups that you mentioned. So if you're somebody that is watching right now and you have questions about a specific advisory group, type it into the comments, and maybe some of those staff directors that help out with those groups can answer those questions for you. Well, that's great, Nicole. We have somebody just said, wow. Yeah, there is a lot to go through. And just a nice comment there from Kimberly Harding. She said, YPN is a great committee for young people to launch their involvement with HAR, which I think you'd agree with that.
Absolutely. I mean, that was where I got started and where I was able to really see the inner workings and what different committees there were and have an opportunity to grow. So that's awesome.
Very good. So what do you recommend to a realtor that's maybe considering getting involved, or maybe they're going to get involved maybe for the first time?
Yeah. So first and foremost, it's put yourself out there and speak to different leaders within the association. I'm always available for those who want to reach out and connect about being involved. You guys can reach out to me through my Facebook or Instagram, and I'm happy to help. But definitely put yourself out there and try. You never know how you can fit into HAR's puzzle until you get out there and actually do it. So just put yourself out there. That's the biggest piece. And then reach out to the different advisory board leaders. There's actually a list on HAR where you can see the different chairs for the different committees, and reach out to them. Everybody's willing to help. These are all people who have been in your shoes and had to start somewhere. Mm-hmm. So I know everybody that is a leader at HAR is very open and willing to help new realtor members get involved.
Absolutely. And that website is hr.com/get involved. We started accepting applications this past Friday, October 1st. So it's open now. You can start applying now. Here's a question that we get a lot, Nicole, and that's, you know, what if I apply for a group and I'm not selected?
Yeah.
And you mentioned that happened to you, right?
Yeah, it happened to me my very first year. Just try again. Consistency is key, because believe it or not, the staff liaison members and the chairs, they see that you've applied several years in a row. And just keep doing it. Don't get discouraged. There's different positions within HAR that, you know, friends of mine have tried for, whether it's board of directors, and they keep coming back. How many times did Shad actually run for board of directors, Christina, before he was elected?
I think it was maybe 5 or 6 times. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, don't give up if you want to make a difference.
Absolutely. Well, Nicole, this has been really helpful. I know that you've shared some great tidbits with our members and hopefully encouraged some new faces to get involved with HAR. Do you have any final thoughts or words for our members that you'd like to share this morning?
Yeah, I mean, really, it's just get involved, stay involved, and know that each person that is involved with the association, no matter how big or small, plays a role in shaping our industry. It's so crucially important that we all get in and support each other and do the best we can for our industry. And one last thing, Christina, before we go, I wanted to mention our very own HAR chair, Richard Miranda, his wife. They were on a trip through Bosnia, Eastern Europe, Bosnia-Herzegovina, and his wife actually suffered 2 seizures and is in intensive care in Bosnia. Their doctors have advised to bring her back to Houston so she can receive the critical and life-saving care and treatments that she needs here through the Texas Medical Center. And she needs to be airlifted back to the States, and unfortunately Richard's insurance is not going to cover that. So I know that there is a GoFundMe that's going around. If you guys could post the link below, he is our 2021 HAR chair, and I know his family would so appreciate the support of our realtor family getting behind them and helping to bring his beautiful wife Doris back to Houston to receive that treatment that she needs.
Absolutely. Thank you for mentioning that, Nicole. And I'm sure we can post that link to the GoFundMe in the comments for Richard and Doris. And of course, our thoughts are definitely with them as they deal with this unfortunate situation. Well, Nicole, thank you again for everything you've mentioned here this morning. We truly appreciate it. Another reminder to our members, hr.com/get involved is where you can apply for any of the advisory groups mentioned here today, and maybe a few others that we might have missed by accident. And also, as Nicole mentioned, HAR's Virtual Engage Conference is October 13th and 14th. Register for that as well. And actually, next Monday, we will have one of the speakers from Virtual Engage on Member Focus Monday. Marquis Lemons-Rael is going to be joining me here to talk all things social media. So, Nicole, you know I'm excited about that.
Oh, yeah. Marquis's amazing. I had the opportunity to meet her several years ago, and she's just a gem. And the same goes for many of the other speakers that we have coming to Engage. So that is the 13th and 14th, you guys, definitely. Get involved and get engaged.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Nicole, for your time this morning. And thank you to all of our members for tuning in. That's it for this Member Focus Monday. We'll see you next Monday at 9 a.m. Have a good week. Bye-bye.